the first thing that you have to do actually is remember to turn on your oven to 180 degrees and let it warm up. You need a brownie tin to bake your brownies in. This one is roughly 20 by 30 centimeters. Some baking paper. Make sure that your baking paper extends over the edge a little bit, because that will make it really easy to lift them out when it's finished. And if you want to make your baking paper stick a little bit, because it always comes out, dab a bit of butter into the bottom of the tray and on the side, and it will keep your paper nicely stuck to the tin. We need half a cup of flour, just normal plain flour going in there, and we have half a cup of cocoa. Now remember, you have to buy proper cocoa powder, not like some kind of funny chocolate drink. And we also need to add 2 cups of sugar. Now I use for this something that the Dutch call bastard suiker, which in Australia would be called caster sugar. The reason I'm using the fine sugar is because it will melt into the cake easier and you won't be left with sugar granules later. Half a cup, 1 cup, 1½, and 2. Also, what I do is I put in some vanilla sugar. The recipe actually calls for vanilla essence in the eggs, but we haven't got vanilla essence, so we'll just use vanilla sugar. Right, flour, cocoa, sugar, vanilla, and literally just a tiny, tiny pinch of salt. And what you need to do then is I make sure with the back of a fork that there are no lumps, because the sugar likes to be a bit lumpy sometimes, and so does the cocoa. So I try and take out all the lumps. I've been asked for this recipe about 150 times, I think, and I love it because I think it's the best brownie recipe ever. At first I didn't really want to share it because it was my own little secret recipe, but I dislike it greatly when I eat something nice and people won't tell me the recipe, and I think the world deserves better brownies. Your next step is to chop about a cup of pecans. I like to use pecans because I think they're possibly the best nut for this recipe. I like them better than walnuts. They're a bit softer and I think the flavor is nicer in a combination with chocolate. And just be careful when cutting, not to cut your fingers, because you don't want any meat in the brownies. You want vegetarians to be able to eat this. And we put that in with our other dry ingredients. And once again, just stir it through. Now, what we're going to do, I'm going to make a well in the center of that, and that's where our chopped chocolate is then going to go. What we're going to do next is melt the butter. You want to melt the butter. You can do it in the microwave if you like. I tend to do it here on the stove on the lowest heat possible, because the microwave tends to do it in patches. And you just have to be careful to do it nice and slow. And while that's melting, we're going to get on and chop. Now, the really important thing here is that you use a good quality chocolate. It must be 72% cocoa solids. It's just not going to taste very good if you're just using ordinary chocolate. And also, make sure that you've chopped them fairly small, because what's going to happen is we're going to pour the melted butter over these chocolate chips, and that will just melt them into the cake batter. You've got 250 grams butter, 250 grams chocolate, 2 cups of sugar, half a cup of cocoa, half a cup of flour, a pinch of salt, vanilla sugar, a cup of pecans, 4 eggs. think pretty much anyone can make this. Now, just remember to check your butter, just to make sure nothing's happening too quickly. Stir it around a little bit. Now, the trick will be to get all this chocolate into our bowl. And remember, make a well in the dry ingredients. Make a well and then heap the chocolate into the well. Alright, so that's our chocolate in the bowl. Crack 4 eggs into a bowl. First, make sure you haven't got eggshell in your egg like we do. Take it out. Just whisk with a fork. And you can usually see when you've whisked enough, you'll get these bubbles happen. And you will notice that when you take your fork through it, it will be more even and smooth. The next thing that's going to happen is that we're going to pour this butter over the chocolate that we've just chopped and put into the well. You put the chocolate in the middle, you pour over the hot butter, which melts the chocolate as you're mixing it into the batter. And as this chocolate is melting, just try and stir the butter through the chocolate first, because the heat of the butter will melt the chocolate pieces adequately. And the chocolate has melted and the sugar has also started melting. That's why it's important to have the fine caster sugar. And then we add our 4 beaten eggs, and we just have to work those into the batter nicely. You have to just pursue and do it nice and slowly, and then eventually the batter will take all the egg. And most importantly, you have to remember to keep thinking happy thoughts when you're making these brownies, so that when people eat them, they feel the happiness that went into making them. When the eggs are all in the brownie mixture properly, you will see how the brownie mixture becomes almost non-stick. You see how it comes away from the bowl? And look, it just kind of pours out of there really easily. Just with the back of the spoon, nice and easily, try and get an even top. Make sure it goes into the corners. Now that's what it looks like going in. And we're going to put it in 180 degrees for about an hour. Okay, 180 degrees Celsius. Just check what time it is now. 16:23, that means. In about an hour, we're going to have brownies. It's about time to take the brownies out now. Careful. I tap the top a little bit just to make sure they're done, and they are.
I'm just going to try a little piece. It's gone.